Hello, welcome to the 2019 city band season. I'm a new old director. I'm Dave Anderson. I've been here before, but most of you were children or weren't here the last time I was. What we're going to do tonight, each concert we've got a different kind of theme, and you're going to see me killing a little time here because you probably saw two of our members just arrive, so I'm going to give them a few minutes to get all set up. But each concert has kind of a theme. That's been the tradition in recent years, and the theme tonight is E Pluribus Unum. E Pluribus Unum was the national motto that was approved by the Congress in 1782, shortly after the Revolution ended, for the Great Seal of the United States. And in Latin, that means out of many, one. So it's very apropos both for the many states that became one nation, the many colonies, and for the many different nationalities and people that came here to the United States and created the one country that we have today. So that's going to be our theme tonight. We have, we're going to open the concert as, probably won't be a surprise if you've been here ever before in the last 50 years. We're going to open it with a song that the band has opened with at least since I started in the band in 1967. It's a song that was written by Irving Berlin that he had originally written for a show, a World War I soldier show called Yip Yip Yep Hank, in which, but for whatever reason, he discarded it, set it aside, didn't use it. And in 1938, one of the most popular radio singers at the time, Kate Smith, asked Irving Berlin for a song that would kind of represent the patriotic feeling in the country as the storm clouds were gathering in Europe. And this song is the song he came up with, God Bless America. Well, we'd be missing the mark if we didn't have a march, a song that used the theme of our program tonight, E Pluribus Unum. Fred Jewell was a band composer, contemporary of John Philip Sousa. He was involved with circuses like Henry Fillmore. And in 1916, he wrote the march E Pluribus Unum, when the patriotic fervor was rising prior to World War I, America's entry into World War I. It was written to represent the idea of America as one country from the many different groups that came here and the many different states becoming the one country. And here is that march. Thank you. At this point, it's been a tradition the last few years to have a guest conductor come in. I guess the conductor usually needs a break about this time. He's worn out after a march like that. We are very lucky tonight. We've got Jim Ortel as our guest conductor, and Jim Ortel should be familiar to most of you if you've been in Lake Mills for any period of time. He was the band director at the high school from 1979 to 2011, right? And was also director of the city band for a number of years in the late 80s, or 80s and early 90s. Yeah, so he's here tonight to direct a couple pieces. Flourish for Wind Band by Ralph Vaughan Williams and Kentucky 1800 is a medley of three different early American folk songs, The Promised Land, Cindy, and I'm Sad and I'm Lonely. And you won't be sad and lonely listening to his work here tonight, Jim Ortel.
Thank you.
You figured this out. I didn't mention, and thank you, Mr. Ortel. Nice job. Gave me a chance to prove what I cannot do on a trumpet. So I appreciate that. Yeah. We're inside tonight. Maybe you didn't notice, but it's raining, you know, out there. So that's why we're inside. But we'll be back on June 26th, and with a good hope I have that we'll be outside in the bandstand. And by the way, that program, the theme of that will be children, children's concerts for the young or those that still act like kids. So it's for me. So, but we've got some, hopefully some surprises for you for that one. That'll be kind of good. The next piece we're going to play represents one of the many nationalities that came to be America and become part of this country. English Folk Song Fantasy represents three different English folk songs that may sound familiar to you because they are a little more difficult arrangement with Ralph Vaughan Williams' Folk Song Suite, so these may sound familiar to you. There's the three different songs within this, which I didn't write down, so I don't remember what they are, but you will recognize them, all right? English Folk Song Suite. We're going to continue with a march by John Philip Sousa, one of his less famous marches, but one that has a special meaning for us here in Wisconsin. This is a march he wrote in 1917, originally called Solid Men to the Front. In 1917, you can figure out maybe why he called it that. America had just entered World War I. Even then, it was dedicated to the students and staff of the University of Wisconsin. After the war, later, before it was published as a band piece, he changed the title to Wisconsin Forward Forever. And you may recognize the trio because for the last 50 years, while Mike Leckrone has been at Madison, that has always been part of the pregame show. We'll march on victorious, oh varsity, varsity fair. Yeah, get the idea. You'll be able to tell it a little better when you hear them play it. So, Wisconsin, forward forever.
Thank you.
Thank you. Now we're going to cover one of the other immigrant groups that came to the United States. Back, you probably know that Lake Mills was largely a German settled community in the 19th century. Cambridge, Stoughton were Norwegian. Well, the Hungarians came here. They tried it at Lake Kashkanan, and it didn't work out in the 1840s. So they moved over to Sauk City. But we're still going to honor them. So we're going to, although not quite as well as we should, maybe, because what we're going to play, it's a Hungarian dance, number 5. It's based on Hungarian themes, but it's written by a German, Johannes Brahms. So Hungarian dance, number 5. Immigrants have come to this country from all over the world. A number of them have come from Asia in the 19th century and in the 20th century. We're going to recognize one of those immigrant groups that came to the United States, Korea, and there was an influx of those after the Korean War, I believe. But this is a piece entitled Folk Song, a Korean Folk Song Medley, and it represents that particular Asian country with three folk songs. Betul Nore, which I mean, what, you know, Google Translator is a wonderful thing, but it means battle song. Odol Dogi, which Google didn't come through for me on that one, so I'm not sure. And the other one was Aryang, which is the unofficial national anthem of South Korea, as I understand it. So those three folk songs, Korean folk song medley. Henry Fillmore was a march composer. He was a contemporary of John Philip Sousa. He was associated very much with circuses. And one of the last marches he wrote was the march we're going to play for you now. It was written in 1928. It was a new march. He hadn't even named it yet. It was played with his band in Cincinnati. And when it was finally published in 1929, the title he decided on was Americans We, and it was dedicated to all of us. So this is Americans We.
Thank you.
little conferencing going on there, but okay. Well, one group of immigrants that came to the United States came against their will. They were the African Americans who were brought over here mainly for purposes of slavery. The blacks had their own form of music that helped them to endure the difficulties that they faced. The spirituals often revolved around religious theme and a hope for a better life in the hereafter. The piece we're going to play for you now is based on a spiritual, Joshua Fit the Battle of Jericho. It's kind of a swing piece, and it's written by Paul Yoder. It's entitled, not surprisingly, Joshua.
Thank you.
Well, as I said earlier, the Lake Mills community was largely of German heritage. I was born here, grew up here, but somehow a Norwegian got mixed in. But primarily, I've heard it's a German community. So, and when I played in the city band years ago in high school and beyond, a lot of the pieces we played were old-time polkas and waltzes and German kind of music. The book that made me laugh for years, I'll say it and they'll start laughing, some of them will, but Whoopie John Wilfart, that was a big polka book that we used to play out of. We're going to play one tonight representing that heritage, the German heritage, and it's a medley of two songs, if you don't recognize them, you need to pull the earplugs out, because I think you will. Little Brown Jug and Beer Here. Majority of the different nationalities that came to the United States in the 19th and early 20th century passed through the port of New York at Ellis Island. And from 1886 on, the Statue of Liberty was there to greet them when they arrived. We're going to recognize the role of New York in a piece of music, the theme from New York, New York, from a movie by Martin Scorsese in 1977, and it was sung by Liza Minnelli in that movie, but probably most of you have heard it with Frank Sinatra singing. And we're going to do it in our own inimitable fashion tonight. New York, New York. Thank you. I want to thank you for being here tonight. I didn't expect, once we were rained out, that we would have this many people here. But there probably are a lot of parents and stuff. So I'm glad you're here. Appreciate it. Hope to see you at the next concert on June 26th. We're going to close tonight, before we do the national anthem, with a piece that is appropriate one to be part of a from many one kind of a theme. Yankee Doodle Boy was written by George M. Cohan. George M. Cohan was he claimed to be born on the 4th of July. He wasn't really, but he made his career as the Yankee Doodle Dandy. And if you ever get a chance to see that movie with Jimmy Cagney, it's a great movie where you see his life. Two of the most famous pieces he did were Yankee Doodle Dandy, You're a Grand Old Flag. He did Over There for World War I. He had a lot of songs. And at one point, supposedly, he had 5 different shows on Broadway at the same time. And by staggering the starting time, he conducted the overture at each of them. So you could tell that maybe he had a little ego thing going there, but yeah. But he was one of the greatest. So this is Yankee Doodle Dandy, George M. Cohan. Yankee Doodle Boy. Yankee Doodle Dandy is the movie. So. Again for being here, and ask that you rise and join us in the singing of the national anthem.